Welcome back to the show, everybody. Now we're going to take some time to break down some film with the segment we call Chopping Wood. Eric Wood, thanks for being with us once again. We're going to break down some film today, and we're going to talk about John Brown, one of the most consistent performers of the Bills' offense. His contributions have happened from week one all the way through this past week against Philadelphia.
Yeah, John Brown has made his impact on this season all year. Over 4 catches in every game, over 50 yards in every game this season. That's him and Michael Thomas only in the NFL to put up that production. And a lot of people feel like Michael Thomas is the best receiver in football. He's been the outside receiver that the Bills have needed. Speed, size, hands, great route running ability.
Well, you know, he's known for as a speed guy. He came out of college and ran the 4.3 40 like some of these guys do. But he's really, actually, we found out in training camp, really good route runners. We see here in this early third down conversion against Philly.
Early on in the game, they had Ronald Darby matched up one-on-one against John Brown. On third down, Josh Allen is generally looking John Brown's way. Here he runs a comeback. And there he uses great physicality at the top of the route, throws Darby by, and there's a lot of contact on both sides there, but he separates. And with John Brown's speed on the comeback routes, and you could probably talk on this, Steve, as a former receiver, you always have the deep threat option with him, and that's what allows him to make these comebacks so easy at times.
Route running and hands and outside the number, what we're really talking about is you go back a week ago and you look at the Miami game. He had the nice touchdown on a skinny post, one-on-one coverage, and Josh Allen perfectly timed. This is exactly the kind of route that scares defenses.
Absolutely, and they get one-on-one coverage here. They identify that by the motion. Great use of the motion by Brian Daboll to identify the coverage pre-snap for Josh Allen. At this point, he knows where he's going with the football. Josh Allen does a great job of holding the safety in the middle of the field with his eyes, and John Brown runs a nice little skinny post right up the seam, and he stacks the defender, and Josh Allen puts a perfect ball. And that's a lot of trust right there based upon the timing that John Brown is going to get open in that situation.
And it's interesting, too, because John Brown's still working with a young quarterback. But at this point, the two of them are starting to work a really nice chemistry. And anytime you're working with a young quarterback, you know he's going to not see it, pull the ball down, and run around. And we get to see some things all the way back in week two of the season with the Giants game about the scramble drill and how these two work together.
Yeah, John Brown's been a security blanket all year for Josh Allen. Earlier in the season, week two, we see Josh Allen. We get some pressure because of a line game up the middle. The defensive end wrapping around. Well, that allows Josh Allen to escape the pocket. He shakes this guy out of his shoes, and then he escapes the pocket. John Brown, you see him, he starts at the bottom of the screen. He is running a route towards the middle of the field, kind of a deep dig route. Well, he just out of it when he sees Josh scrambling, stays alive, creates separation with that speed we mentioned, and Josh Allen delivers a great ball. So that's a huge third down conversion in that game.
You know, John Brown's a guy who's a savvy vet. He learned a lot from working in his years in Arizona with Larry Fitzgerald, and now we're facing a team in Washington coming up this week. They've got their own young wide receiver in Terry McLaurin, who came out. He's another guy who's extremely fast, and the Bills' secondary is going to have to contend with him. But if you look at Washington, he's one of the few weapons that they're really depending on this year.
Yeah, he's having a lot of production already with over 400 yards on the season. Third rounder out of Ohio State, a rookie this year. Not one of the biggest names coming into this draft, but then he goes to the combine. He posts a 4.35 40, and now this year he's had great production. And for a struggling Washington offense, like you mentioned, one of the bright spots, here you see great route running ability. He's at the bottom of the screen, sells the route inside with his eyes, flips back around, and Case Keenum delivers a great ball on the outside for a touchdown against the Dolphins.
Now, he's known for his speed, no question about it, with a 4.35 40 coming out. But he also has the physicality as well. In the game against the Chicago Bears, he goes up and makes a real physical catch against the Bears.
Yeah, here we're going to see Terry. He's at the point in this bunch set. So he's right in the middle of the three receivers at the bottom. And here you're going to see great physicality at the top. And that's tough to defend. These routes in the red zone, the windows get tighter. It's very physical down there. He shows great physicality to get just enough separation and then shows the strength to catch that ball through the ground.
Well, he is a young receiver who's having a lot of success. And one of the reasons, obviously, is his physicality, but also it's the 4.35 speed. And we'll see it here against the Philadelphia Eagles.
Yeah, here he's simply beating the Eagles over the top. And this is something that we saw earlier in the year, similar to a John Ross for Cincinnati, a guy who can simply take the top off the defense. You always have to be aware of where he's at on the field because these huge plays can dramatically impact the game. And for a Bills team, they're third in the league in giving up points. they're not looking to give up any big plays and give anybody any cheap points.
What's it take to stay on top of a receiver who's that fast and is always on the field?
Yeah, you got to stay disciplined as a corner, and then schematically, you want your safeties to always create some leverage behind them, to always be in a position where they can play that ball over the top. And with a guy that's fast, I often say if he's even, he's leaving. So you always need to be on top of the receiver, because if you get even with him, he's going to smoke you to the uprights.
Eric, thanks for your insights. We appreciate it. We'll be looking forward to the radio call on Sunday.
Thanks, Steve.